it suggested that maybe there's some kind of path forward. I do not think that this is what the Chief Justice bargained for. And I have to think that the Chief Justice, who was himself a senior Justice Department official and who prized the Justice Department's credibility in court, will have very little patience for this chaotic scene we've seen over the past couple of weeks. So I don't know that the administration had much of a shot in the wake of last month's decision. But with each passing day, it really becomes quite remote that they could get 5 votes on the Supreme Court to sustain whatever new rationale they come up with.
Why do you think the administration is fighting this so hard at this point? Why keep pursuing these strategies that seem very unlikely to actually succeed in putting this question on the census?
Well, there are two reasons. I think one of them is political. The president doesn't like to lose, would rather fight and show his base how committed he is to these issues, even at the expense of an ultimate loss. But the other is, let's not lose sight of, Michael, this is a big deal. If this question goes on the census, it will really alter response rates. It'll alter the allocation of billions of dollars of federal funds. It'll alter the allocation of congressional seats. So we've been talking about litigation maneuvers and who's telling the truth about what. But the bottom line, the larger point here, is that whatever the answer is, it's going to have a big impact.
She get a ride?
The way American democracy happens and the way all kinds of federal money is spent. So the stakes are awful high. So from the
No, they do not. She likes her rides. She's getting huge. I mean, seriously, she's like, I think she's going to be bigger than 44 pounds. Ha ha ha. Rhonda! She's trying to go through your legs. She's seriously. Do you feel her? Oh my god. She's like, her head's on your shirt. There she goes. Go ahead, Rhonda. Here's what else you need to know today.
About President Trump, or leaked to the news media, and President Trump said he knew
honest assessment of the Trump administration.
Good government depends on public servants being able to give full and frank advice. I want all our public servants to have the confidence to be able to do that.
Anne. Good afternoon.
During a news conference on Wednesday, President Labor Secretary Alexander Ocasio offered his most forceful defense yet of a 2008 agreement which he oversaw to not bring federal charges against Jeffrey Epstein.
Facts are important, and facts are being overlooked. Simply put, the Palm Beach State Attorney's office was ready to let Epstein walk free. No jail time, nothing.
Acosta said that his office reached the agreement after determining that Steve